and we're at the stoplight, and I remember reaching my hand over and grabbing Michael's hand, and I looked at him and I said, our lives are about to change forever. And he goes, it's gonna be okay. And I said, it's not gonna be okay.
Down on my knees again tonight. Hoping this prayer.
They sent us into the recovery room. Aiden was still not fully awake, and they came in and they got us. And I knew this was not good. They brought us into this room. There was the neurologist and another doctor, and they brought in a child specialist therapist. They basically said, your child has a brain tumor. And if we do nothing, he has 1 to 2 months to live. If we do radiation, we might be able to buy you a year. And that's all we got for you. You guys were able to just create this community around us, because I truly believe without that story being ran on your station, we wouldn't have had those people come and sit at nights with Aiden. We wouldn't have had the people attend fundraisers that helped us out so tremendously, because both the first time when Aiden was diagnosed, Mike didn't work for almost a year. And then when Aiden was diagnosed, when it came back, he didn't work for 6 months. This is a single income family. Only Mike's income is what we lived off of, you know? And we stuck to our guns about, we aren't going to go back on this. We're going to only talk about Aiden surviving. We're not going to talk about him dying. And they kept saying, you need to talk to him about, you know, you need to be honest with him. And we kept telling them, what more do we need to be honest about? Aiden knows about heaven, and he knows about God, and he knows what the dying means, you know, but we don't need to tell him he's dying. There's no sense, because we don't believe he's dying, because we didn't. In fact, you know, when Aiden actually went, I was in shock.
It's the news that no one hopes for. Every parent's greatest fear. Finding out the child you love so much might not make it through the year. Now the thought of spending Christmas without him just feels wrong.
The night of November 23rd, Mike, myself, Sage, and my parents decided to play a game, a board game. We're playing a board game down here on the floor. And I look up at Aiden, and his color doesn't seem right. He looks, because the bed was right here in the living room, and his color wasn't right. And I'm like, what's going on? And we get up to him, and we're having to shake him. And he starts breathing again. He had stopped breathing. It's now the next day, and everybody's here. And Mike says he's going to go up and shower. And I decided to lay next to Aiden. And I got up on the bed, and I laid next to him. And I kind of dozed on and off, you know, because I was tired. I hadn't been sleeping. And there's home movies on the TV where everybody was watching movies of Aiden. And I'm kind of watching, and I'm dozing off, and then something wakens me, and I look at him, and he's all blue in his face, and I'm like, Aiden, and I'm trying to shake him. And then, of course, we had stethoscopes all over this house, and I grab one, and I listen, and there was a heartbeat, but then it stopped. And then Mike and Sage and myself sang to him as he passed away. And I used to always sing to him, "You Are My Sunshine." And Holy Sanctum, you are our sunshine. And then he was free.
You are my sunshine, my only sunshine. You make me happy.
A lot of people are scared to bring him up to us. Like, they're, you know, and I understand. I understand why. They're afraid it'll bring back bad memories or bad whatever. But the fact of the matter is, whether you say anything to me or not, I'm thinking about him. So you're not, you know, you're not bringing up something I'm not already thinking about. And what you do when you do that is you let us know that he made a difference. Positive Life just brought to us all the blessings that we so needed at such dark times. It's such support and feeling that you're not alone. I think that's so important when somebody's going through a hard time and being able to feel that you're not alone. And Positive Life was able to do that for us. Through the prayers, through the positive message that we were able to get through the radio and through the songs and being able to just have those feelings of being lifted back up.